Now to this major development in the case of the student athlete's bizarre death at his high school in Valdosta, Georgia. 17-year-old Kendrick Johnson was found dead, his face battered in this rolled up gym mat at his high school in January. Police said that Kendrick suffocated trying to grab a shoe, but his parents didn't buy that. They said there is no way that this is a cover-up, that they have the pictures to prove it. And the Justice Department recently confirmed it is taking a second look at the case here. Now we have gotten word that Johnson's body will be exhumed for a second autopsy. CNN's Victor Blackwell has been all over this story for us. First, want to warn you, you obtained this photo of Kendrick Johnson's face after his death. It is included in your report that we're about to run for you, so just a heads up.
Yeah.
It is very graphic, so please be advised. Here's the story.
I wish this on no one.
Kenneth and Jacqueline Johnson of Valdosta, Georgia want to know who killed their son. A judge has now given them permission to exhume the body of their child. The Johnsons think the official explanation of how 17-year-old Kendrick Johnson died is a cover-up.
We examined all the alternatives that were presented to us, and the only one that fit the physical evidence and the forensic evidence and the testimonial evidence that we received was this is an accident.
In January, Kendrick was found upside down in a rolled gym mat like these. In statements released by Lowndes County Sheriff's Office, students wrote, "We always leave our shoes inside the mats during class, but to retrieve the shoes, we tilt the mats over and get the shoes from the bottom." This is Kendrick inside the mat. His family's attorney gave us this photo. Detectives think Kendrick reached for a black gym shoe from the top of the 6-foot mat, slipped into the center, and got stuck while no one was around. And a relative says the shoes in this picture are his too. The official cause of death is positional asphyxia. In other words, he was smothered by his own body weight.
Said it was no foul play. He had no bruises, no nothing.
Did you believe that?
No.
And you still don't believe it?
No, I don't.
This picture of Kendrick's face reinforced their suspicions.
As handsome as my son was, then you see him like that, it's crazy.
According to the paramedics report, there was bruising noted to right side jaw, although there was no mention of bruising in the state's autopsy report.
Well, I didn't know what to think.
Coroner Bill Watson was called to the scene 5 hours after detectives had arrived, although Georgia law requires investigators to call the coroner as soon as a body is found.
The body had been moved. The scene, in my opinion, had been compromised.
It's a very time-consuming process to basically work your way from the outside in. Once our investigators got to the deceased, the coroner was contacted immediately.
In May, when we asked Watson about his concerns, he told us that he and the sheriff had taken care of the discrepancy internally.
I really feel he was murdered.
At least two students told detectives there'd been a dispute over a girl. And on the day Kendrick's body was found, another student posted on Facebook, "When you start messing the goons, bodies start showing up." And soon after, that Facebook account had been deactivated. Detectives questioned a schoolmate about a Facebook posting, but did not connect him to Kendrick's death. Hundreds have rallied for a federal investigation, and the Department of Justice is reviewing the case.
No matter who you are, how much money your parents have, the color of your skin, everyone deserves justice. Everyone.
The sheriff's office stands behind its investigation. Johnson says he won't stop until he finds out who killed his son.
Wow. Victor Blackwell joins me here again. Thank you for staying on the story.
Sure.
And two questions. One, when we saw the photo, you could see his feet and his socks, and those were shoes.
Yes.
Next to his feet.
His shoes, those gray and orange shoes, and that's a question the family asks. If he dove into this mat, how did the shoes end up in
next
the mat
him.
After him, next to him? They are mentioned in this report as part of the narrative, but the sheriff's office and the crime lab, they don't mention those shoes as part of the theory of how he died.
Interesting. Yeah. What about the Department of Justice case review? Where are we on that?
Well, the U.S. attorney in Georgia, Michael Moore, has been reviewing this case for a little more than a week now, almost 2 weeks, and he's at the point where he wants to speak with the family. But the family's attorney says, wait a minute, that autopsy you're reviewing, the statements you're reviewing, those reports, they say they have questions about the credibility of those reports. So they now want to speak with those students, get their own statements, and that's part of the reason they want to exhume Kendrick's body, because they want their own forensic pathologist in Florida to conduct an autopsy to find out if there's anything that leads them to an end that he was killed or there was some type of foul play.
Let us know where they go with that. Victor, thank you.
Sure.